Well, look, I think these are the trillion-dollar club getting together. $1 billion is probably a drop in the ocean for both of them. It's over 5 years. And what I think the aim of this at the end of the day is to try and automate and speed up as much of the partly the drudgery of doing lab work, because lab work, just like as if you were a doctor in a clinical setting, you need to take a lot of notes, a lot of details. But at the same time, I think they're investing in what appears to be automating 24/7 experiments, things that human beings just can't do. And I know, having been a scientist, that sometimes your life is on hold because you have to go back and deal with your experiments, your cells, or whatever it is that you're running. And so a lot of these things, I think, could speed up and also make the life of the scientist a little bit easier. At the end of the day, though, I think the aim here is to try and get scientific discoveries translated to drugs quicker and get them to market quicker.
Sam, what does this mean for Eli Lilly's rivals? Do you expect that we'll see some of its competitors also ramp up their AI endeavors, given its partnership with a company like Nvidia?
Well, a lot of pretty much all pharma companies, and I just want to point you to a recent survey that BI, Bloomberg Intelligence, has done that looked at 10 different industries, one of which being the pharmaceutical industry, asked executives, what are you doing with this? What are you trying to get to? What is the aim at the end? Everybody is at this. This is not something specific to Lilly. And you know, Google, for example, has through DeepMind, has created an agentic AI called Google Scientist. It's like, I think, four agents or five agents who interact with each other and check each other's hypotheses. So a lot of this is going on in all companies. But of course, here we have Lilly, one of the richest pharma companies around in terms of the amount of cash flow that it's got, really being able to spend the money without really impacting its balance sheet and cash flow. And I'm pretty sure everybody's at this, but clearly this is the news du jour, if you like.
Absolutely. Like you said, it's a drop in the bucket for both of these companies. But when you have a number like $1 billion and these big
A
brand
good number.
names, it gets people's attention. What also
Absolutely.
gets my attention, Sam, is Moderna. Moderna, obviously one of the vaccine makers during the pandemic, but it's had a rough go at it recently because it's so dependent on these vaccines. And we have an administration that is kind of anti-vaccine right now. Yet, Moderna pre-announced at the JP Morgan Healthcare Conference that its US COVID business did better than expected. Is Moderna starting to stabilize?
Well, one would hope so. They've stuck with their aim of growing 2026 by 10%. But you know, if you look back at the beginning of the year, where the company in 2025 started with guidance and where we ended up, we're a good $500-600 million short of what the hope was at the beginning of the year. So everybody, I think, knows that this is a very difficult market to call for exactly the reasons you just highlighted. There is a constant change in the way that the administration in the US, and not just the US, elsewhere, is also dealing with vaccination, particularly in the COVID side of things. Other vaccinations are still pretty much well settled in at least outside the US. The problem also that Moderna is going to face or has been facing is that there are lots of people. There's, I think my patent colleagues say there are at least 20 various directions of legal cases or trials going on. Different groups saying you're infringing my patents or you infringe my patents and you need to, because there was billions and billions of dollars of revenues. So some of that is coming potentially in the March timeframe for Eli Lilly against a trial coming up against Arbutus, another company that's listed in the US. So some of that is, I think, something that might keep people from getting too excited about Moderna's guidance today.